diseases of cotton. So now you will see the list of important diseases in cotton. So my name is N.H. Shankar Reddy and I am doing PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. So coming to the list of important diseases, so these are the list of important diseases in cotton. So first one is Fusarium wilt, which is caused by Fusarium oxysporum Pharma specialis vis infectum, and anthracnose, which is caused by Colporteum capsici, Cercospora leaf spot, which is caused by Cercospora gossypina, and then rust, which is caused by Pacospora gossypi, and root rot, otherwise called as Texas root rot, which is caused by Pimetotrichum omnivorum, and then Verticillium wilt, which is caused by Verticillium dahliae, and angular leaf spot or black or bacterial blight of cotton, which is very important one, which is a bacterial disease, which is caused by Xanthomonas auxinopodis pathover malvasiarum. And then finally, boll rot, which is a complex disease, which is caused by Fusarium moniliform or Colporteum capsici, Aspergillus flavus and Aspergillus niger, which is a complex one. So now we'll see in detail about one by one. So the first one is Fusarium wilt, which is caused by Fusarium oxysporum Pharma species vis infectum. So coming to the symptoms, on the right side we can clearly observe the symptoms. So mainly yellowing can be clearly seen, we can see here, yellowing can be clearly seen in in the entire leaf. We can also see the brown color discoloration along with the yellowing discoloration can be seen. So here the major symptoms we can see here in later stages, what will happen, loss of turbidity, yellowing, dropping of leaves and wilting of leaves can be observed. So the final at the final stage, complete wilting or drying of seedlings can happening. So here the browning and blackening of vascular discoloration can also be observed on stem, as well as it spreads to upward direction from downward to upward direction. And the Fusarium wilt infected plant will produce few number of bolls. So hope you guys will know boll is the infected, boll is the economic part of cotton where the cotton is packed inside the boll. So Fusarium wilt infected plant will produce a less amount of bolls. So coming to the management aspects, acid delinting of seeds, it is one of the very important and major practice that can be practiced, where we can dip the seeds in concentrated sulfuric acid, and along with carboxyl and or carbendazim at the rate of 4 gram per kilogram can be also be recommended, and removing and burning of infected plant debris after after yield, harvesting, and then a deep summer plowing also can be recommended, especially during June and July, especially during in Indian condition, we can sense high temperature, especially during April, May and June time. So it's better to go with the summer deep plowing, so that the if there is any insects or some other materials will be there, or some fungal inoculum will be there, that can be destroyed if it is exposed to high temperature. And also can increase the dosage of application of potash, and can minimize the better to minimize the or balanced application of nitrogenous fertilizers, as well as phosphatic fertilizers. So the main reason for the application of potash is here that can increase the resistance, and two types of resistance we can observe: drought resistance and as well as disease resistance. And then application of heavy doses of farmyard manure and organic manures at the rate of 100 ton per hectare can be recommended. It will be very difficult to go with 100 ton or 200 tons. Mostly we can recommend 12.5 tons of farmyard manure per hectare can be recommended, but I suggest you go with 20 to 30 tons of farmyard manure. So that will be heavy application of farmyard manures can give a more amount of provide more nutrition, so that the disease can be escaped. And a spot drenching or soil drenching with the Benamil at the rate of 0.05% or carbendazim at the rate of 0.1% can be recommended. So the second one is anthracnose, which is caused by Colporteum capsici or Glomerella gossypi. So coming to the symptoms, we can see here the infected seedlings or seeds produce reddish or circular spots can be seen on leaves, primarily on leaves, and we can also see on the cotyledonces, and some water soaked lesions or reddish color lesions can also be seen on leaf regions. So the mainly we can see here complete initially the small purple or reddish color leaves spots can appear. later stages they produce complete reddish. We can see here complete reddish spots can be seen, very big spots can be seen on, especially in leaves. And they can, you know, the ball size also can be reduced, as well as bract size, internodes, and all the sizes will be completely reduced. But the major symptoms we can see are and leaves, we can reddish brown color, reddish color discoloration can be seen on leaves, and occasionally we can also see on bowls also. On the right side we can see here bowls also we can also observe the same symptoms. So coming to the management aspects, again, acid delinting of seeds and along with or otherwise we can go with Kapton or Thyram or Carboxin at the rate of 2 gram per kilogram of seed can be recommended. And soil drenching the crop at bole formation, especially during bole formation stage, at the rate of 2 kilogram per hectare of mancozib or 500 grams per hectare of carbendazim can be recommended. So third one is Cercospora leaf spot. So which is caused by Cercospora gossypina. So the name itself indicate leaf spots. So irregular grey color spots or dark brown color blackish spots can be seen on leaves, especially we can see on leaves. So as I told you, as we discussed in earlier presentations, then the mostly the disease symptoms will be described in the name itself, the disease name itself. Name itself indicates leaf spots. So spots will appear on leaves. So the maybe the color of leaves, the color of spots maybe varies from disease to disease. Here in Cercospora leaf spot, we can see dark brown or blackish borders can be clearly seen on the leaves. So coming to the management aspects, remove and destroy the infected plant residues, and along with spraying of mancozib or copper oxychloride at the rate of 2 gram per hectare can be recommended. And 2 to 3 sprayings can be given at 15 to 30 days intervals. Either maybe copper oxychloride or mancozib sprays can be given at 2 to 3 days at 15 days interval of each. So the next one is root rot, which is caused by Rhizoctonia pediaticola. The name itself indicates root rot, rottening of roots. Here we can see the seedlings or the germination seedlings can be rotted, and we can see the stem and death of seedlings can be observed. We can see improper filling or death of seedlings can be seen along with dried stem or the dried root region. So the here if we see the affected the basal stem region or the affected root region, so we can clearly observe the shedding of roots. We can see here shedding of roots. If we cut up, if you open that bark region, we can clearly that discoloration of brown color or black color discoloration of stem, as well as sclerotial formation also can be observed in the later stages or in severe stages of crop growth. So the root system get rotted in later stages, entire root get rotted, and the plant will die, because the if the root system will get completely affected or completely destroyed, the plant able to suck the nutrients or can't able to pull out the nutrients that is required by the plant. So that we can see the later stages of black color discoloration as death of plant, as well as formation of a sclerotia also can be observed on the later stages. Especially this sclerotia can be seen on basal stem regions just above the soil region. We can see this black color discoloration, and sometimes we can also observe on the above stem region also. So coming to the management aspects, treat the seeds with the Trichoderma viridi at the rate of 4 gram per kilogram of seeds, or the Pseudomonas fluorescens, it's a bacterial biocontrol agent, at the rate of 10 gram per kilogram of seeds can be recommended. And along with the seed treatment with the Carboxin or Thyram at the rate of 5 gram, or Carbendazim at the rate of 2 gram per kilogram can be recommended. And soil drenching with 0.1% of Carbendazim or 0.05% of Binomial also can be recommended. And application of farm-made manure at the rate of 10 tonnes per hectare, or the neem cake at the rate of 2.5 tonnes per hectare can be recommended. And also it's better to adjust the date of sowing or time of sowing. So earlier sowing exactly at the first week of April, or the late sowing or the on the last week of June can escape this disease because of a high soil temperature condition. So it's the plant can able to escape out from this disease. And adopting intercropping with sorghum or mock bean, that is Fasciolus aconitifolius, to reduce the soil temperature or lower the soil temperature is one of the management aspects. So coming to the next one, verticillium wilt, which is caused by Verticillium dahliae. So here this Verticillium wilt mainly affects the bole formation. So mainly affects bowl formation, we can clearly see the most important symptom in verticillium viltis, not only in cotton but also in other verticillium viltis. Intervenal chlorosis can be seen along with the scorching of leaves. The same scorching that we will see in disease of grapes. So in disease of grapes, the same type of scorching also can be seen in one disease that I will explain you in disease of grapes. But in verticillium wilt, chlorosis along with the scorching of leaves can be observed here, along with some most important symptom, or very very important symptom, is tiger stripe symptom or tiger claw symptoms can be here. We can see here tiger stripe symptoms or tiger claw symptoms can be seen in verticillium wilt. So the affected plants will produce discoid and less amount of bolls are produced. Even though if the bolls are produced, the size of the boll is greatly reduced. So that is the verticillium wilt. So coming to the management aspects, acid delinting along with application of seed treatment with carboxin or carbendazim at the rate of 4 gram per kilogram of seeds can be recommended, along with the removing, destroying of seeds and deep summer flowing, especially during June, July days. And application of farmyard manure at the rate of 100 tons. I don't know 100 tons can be recommended or not, but I can say 12 to 15 tons. Maybe you can go for 20 tons. I don't think you will get 100 tons per hectare. It will be too much. I think it would be better to go with 10 to 15 tons. But the most recommended one is 12.5 tons per hectare of farmyard manure can be recommended for almost all diseases. But I suggest you, if you want to apply heavy dosages, then you may go for 15 tonners or 20 tonners. More than that, it will be useless. And following of crop rotation with the paddy or lucerne or chrysanthemum for 2 to 3 years will also give relief from this verticillium wilt. And along with soil drenching with 0.5% of binomial or 0.1% of carbendazim can give great control on this disease. So coming to the leaf blight, the name itself indicates blightening of leaves, and which is caused by Alternaria macrospora. So the name itself indicates, as I told you, blightening of leaves. We can see here small pale color or blackish black color or brown color irregular spots can be seen on leaves. The pale or blackish to brown color irregular spots can be seen on leaves. In severe cases, alternation or concentric ring spots can be observed on the severe stages or on the next stages of disease development. So here the bowl size also can be reduced. Eventually in later stages, what will happen due to severe infestation, the leaves will defoliate and fall from the stems. So coming to the management aspects, removing and destroying of infected plants along with spraying of mancozeb or copper oxychloride at the rate of 2 gram per kilogram can be recommended. And some of the resistant varieties like K7, K8, MCU5 and Jayadar are the resistant varieties available against this disease. So the last one is bacterial blight. It's a very important one in cotton. So which is caused by Xanthomonas campestris pathover malvasiarum. So the 5 common symptoms that can mainly observe in cotton bacterial wilt. The first one is seedling blight. So the name itself indicates blightening of seedlings. So here in seedling blight, water-soaked lesions or circular irregular lesions can be seen on cotyledons. Here angular leaf spot, the name itself indicates spots can be observed, or angular shaped spots can be observed on lower surface of leaves. Sometimes in the later stages we can also observe the same spots on the upper surface, or raised spots can on the upper surface. So here angular or reddish color spots are especially appears or mainly appears on the wean regions, and rarely we can also see on the side to the wean regions. So mostly we can see these spots and especially in the wean regions. The next symptom is a black wean. The name itself indicates weans become blacks, or wean becoming some blackened, and weanlets also turned into black in color. That gives the blighting appearance. So coming to the next one, black arm. The name itself indicates, so the stem hangs typically where the cracking and breaking symptoms can be seen, and also the arm will convert it into black in color. That's why it's called as black arm. So the final one is bowl rot, which is caused by the symptoms of bowl rot is mainly we can see the black color discoloration on the bowl. We can see here black color discoloration, or slowly white color mycelium also can be observed. We can see here it's not white color mycelium. Actually, it's a bacterial disease. White color ooze out. Sorry, it's not a mycelium or something else. It's a ooze out. Okay. So the infection initially appears a dark green color soaked spots are appears on the bald region. So because it's a very serious disease, the main reason is so for cotton, the bolds are the economic parts where the cotton that sponge is packed inside. So the cotton is packed inside. So if it is get affected, the poor quality of cotton or improper filling of cotton can be happen. So that's a very severe disease for the farmers who are going who are growing cotton. So here the bacterium this bacterium can affect initially on bones bolts, and then later becomes this bolt slowly starts to die. So if we cut open or if we see this infected portion, yellow color discoloration can be seen on the inside, and ooze out of the bacterium also can be seen, especially as I told you, this white color area is bacterial ooze out. So it's a very important disease, as I told you. So coming to the management aspects, remove and destroy the infected plant debris, and along with the cotton delinting of cotton seeds with the concentrated sulfuric acid at the rate of 100 ml per kilogram of seeds can be recommended, and soak the seeds with 1000 ppm of streptomycin sulfate, is a bacterial antibiotic. So along with the spraying streptomycin sulfate or tetracycline mixture at the rate of 100 gram with the copper oxychloride at the rate of 2 kg per hectare can be recommended, or the spraying of copper oxychloride at the rate of 2.5 kg per hectare can be recommended. And some of the resistant varieties are available against this boldworm or bacterial blight. That is Sujata 1412 and CRH71 are the resistant varieties available against this disease. So coming to the questions related to ARS or NET, we can mostly expect this bacterial blight, which is caused by Xanthomonas campestris pathoverm alveciarum. And they can also ask what is the chemical recommended in acid delinting, that is concentrated sulfuric acid, and they can ask something like this, what is acid delinting and for which disease it is recommended, something like that they will ask. So along with that, maybe the chance of causing causal organism, but this bacterial blight is very, very important one in cotton, and acid delinting also one of the possible chance of asking. I think I had seen it in maybe in 2017 while I was writing some MSc entrance exam, something like that. So this is about cotton.